Women empowerment, and that after kazi, apate kazi, ndio siyahitaji mwanaume ameshani mwake. You know? That's also part of trauma, isn't it?
That's a lot of trauma. And that trauma happens, especially while growing up. You know, we are told that we all learn by imitation. So at times you see what is happening, and you know this is how life should be. And when a child comes to this earth, the first teachers are parents. Mm. So when they see the parents fighting every day, they feel like, I do not want to get into that part of my life. It's like a part of their lives they want to escape, because it has pain, it has tears, it has aggression, and it has stress. So what happens as they're growing up, if nobody comes to change that school of thought, then they get into adulthood knowing all men are like this. Mm. And if it's a boy whose mom used to be beaten, they all grow up, whose dad used to be beaten. They all grow up knowing all women are aggressive.
Right.
So what happens for them, they don't do it because they are bad. They do it because they are cushioning themselves from that hurt and from that pain.
Yeah.
And unless they meet somebody who can be like a role model and tell them, no, it works, and they see it actually working, most of them now get a different mindset.
Yeah.
And the mindset is, I'm going to navigate around this issue of marriage because I don't want to be beaten the way my mom or my dad used to quarrel or fight. So unless those people meet a different school of thought, they are going to actually escape marriage.
Yeah.
And that's a group that is saying, I do not mind having a baby. That's their saying.
Yeah.
I do not mind this. I don't mind the other. But I do not want to be in a marriage. That's a group that is saying, I'll get a good job. I'll get this, but I'll never marry. And you're having men who are past, let's say, 30, 40, even mid-40s, and they don't actually consider much about marriage. And ladies who don't consider, because they still have that trauma.
Yeah.
That trauma is still affecting them. It has not been dealt with. It has not been healed. And if they get married, they get married from the wrong side of marriage.
Yes.
That I'm getting there with defense.
There are men also who will get into, they go through traumatic experiences in this sense, whereby they will beat their women or their wives because they saw what maybe their mother did. Their mother maybe was a cheat. Na wanajuanga, ukiona mwanamke amekuja na nguo mpya, na si wewe umenunua, amenunuliwa na mwanaume mwingine. Ukiona mama yako amekuja na kiatu mpya, au rada bibi yako amekuja na kiatu mpya, na si wewe umenunua, ni mwanaume mwingine amenunua. So, kula yema ngumi. Isn't that also somewhat stressful?
It's a disorder. It's actually a disorder. Because you see, at the end of the day, we were saying, everybody learns, either by watching or by hearing. Probably the man used to hear the father say, wewe nguo umetoa kwa mzee mwingine. So they would keep on hearing those arguments. And that's why we say, when a couple is having an argument, don't do it before your children.
Right.
Because something is being recorded in their mind. And so when they get into their relationship and they see probably their lady maybe begin to be defiant, or they see a new dress and then they see defiance, they connect with what they had a long time ago. It's just like a lesson. The way you go, today you know probably to find the circumference of a circle is pi D. So it's already written in you because you are taught.
Yeah.
So there is also the same person who was taught by the father. While he didn't know he was doing that, he told the man that if you see a woman behave this way, the only way you can do is engage into a physical fight. And that will require a change of mentality.
Right.
Because the moment you begin to beat your wife, as I said, it becomes a spiraling thing. It will, your kids will see it. They'll probably pick it in the wrong way. And instead of now beating their spouse, they kill them. Naturally, you'll find some of these things that happen in a relationship, it continues down the way and becomes worse and worse as it goes down, unless somebody breaks that pattern.
Yeah.
And that's why today we also be looking at that issue of how do you break out of that cycle?
Yes. Traumatic experiences also manifest in very many ways. There are men who, and even women, of course, who will withdraw because they feel helpless in this situation. They feel as though there's nothing they can do about it. Even if there are solutions out there, but growing up, they never saw those solutions.
Yeah.
They never felt as though they were protected in any way whatsoever. So is that also a process of trauma? Let's talk about that in a minute. I understand we have a phone call. K24, good morning.
Good morning, Guvi. How are you?
I'm very fine, Kagwema. Habari yako?
Mzuri sana. I'm Kagwema from Limuru.
Yes.
Congratulations to that wonderful couple who do a good job as far as issues are concerned.
Asante sana.
Thank you.
I want to comment on the post-traumatic relationship problems.
Right.
And start by pointing out that there's something very, very important in one's life called family of origin. So family of origin, anything that happens in one's family of origin influences what happens in a relationship.
Yes.
Like if you grow up seeing that your mother was beaten, your father was harassed, there was an abuse of any sort, you are likely to replicate that in your relationship when you get married.
True.
So some things like that. You enter a marriage with a lot of trauma, which is not resolved. And then when you hook up with a husband or a wife, he beats you up or something, it reignites that trauma, that childhood trauma that you went through.
Right.
So I think it's very important for people to understand self-awareness, to know how did you grow up? Is your relationship getting affected by what happened in your family of origin?
Yes.
And of course, counseling is the way forward.
Yes.
Understanding that problem is there, confronting it, counseling is the way forward. Personally, I've never I've had such a thing, and I think because I'm a counselor, that's why maybe I'm doing that.
Yes.
But I can assure you, issues of trauma are very, very many, and they are very, very dangerous in a relationship.
Okay.
And with that one, they lead to blood pressure, they lead to heart attacks, they lead to alcoholism, addiction, and a lot of other abuses.
Okay.
So the sooner they address, the better, through psychotherapy.
Thank you so much.
Say hi to that wonderful couple. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kagwema. Always a pleasure to have you on the show and having you give us your contribution. I like what he said about the family of origin. Let's take a look at WhatsApp as well. I am Esther, tuned in from Kisumu. I grew up watching physical abuse happen to someone dear to me. I always had that fear that the same may happen to me when growing up up to a point of deciding not to get married in future. But I am thankful I overcame that trauma with time, and I am now happily married. Well, Esther, congratulations to you.
Wonderful.
Let's see. Good morning. I am JJ from Bihiga. My question. I have had two relationships, and I became the most hurt, because in all of them, I am the one who fell in love. Dr. Jane, that one is for you. I had this guy take me home to see his parents. We planned to go see mine too, but he bailed out on me, cheated on me, and married another lady. Then I started dating again. Later, I came to find out the guy was married and cheating on me with three more girls. I have lost faith in love. I cannot trust anyone now, and I'm even thinking of a life with no kids or marriage.
Mambo.
That was yours, but let's start with you, Jane. That lady. Go.
The gentleman who fell in love twice and he was left very hurt. Apologize, Sana, for that. You cannot ignore your feelings. The worst you can do is to say that you are not hurt or you shouldn't be hurt. Legally, you are hurt, and we sympathize with you. However, I want us to look at it beyond that. What lesson should it teach? Because any situation that happens in life, you should not now make it like, you know, this is the end of me, that I stagnate here, I'm fixated, I'm not going to love again. The thing you should ask yourself, were these ladies prepared for you? Because you gave out your heart to women who are not yet ready for you. So next time when you meet a lady, before you fall in love, start with friendship. Ensure she's equally your friend. Don't start looking at a lady and imagining marriage. First of all, look at a lady and imagine a friend. Then let it grow from friendship to love. You will know whether it is mutual or not. And again, women don't like a man who hurries too much. You know, you just met and now you know I'm in love. I want to marry. I'm in love. You know, women like men who watakazia kidogo hivi, lakini sio sana. So I think even next time, put a guard. You know, we are told to put a guard in our heart, our emotions. So look at every lady, the one you spot and you think she can be your friend because you have feelings for her. Make sure you grow it as friendship.
But
you have a better day. Your right person is coming.
Mimi niko nako kashida kakupendana sana haraka sana. Mimi nikikupenda ni hivyo. Why are we wasting time? For why? Doctor, why are we wasting time?
Ni kweli.
For why?
Unajua hata lakini unajua hata ukipata shamba mahali na uipende sana.
Unanunua haraka bila pande
bei. Usiingie tu hapo haraka mara moja. Do a due diligence.
Okay. Yes.
Ujue kama ni ya wenyewe na kama inauzwa.
Okay.
Exactly.
Buvi.
No.
Eh, nimekusikia. Mimi niko na familia. Tulishamaliza hii maneno.
No, yeye anapenda anapenda watu sana.
Yes.
Now there is that lady who has said that her issue is that she got into a relationship.
Yeah.
Then it broke up because the guy bailed out on her.
Mm-hmm.
And again, another one. Let me say this. You know, sometimes you may say that you are probably even, there are people who say that I'm in a curse.
Mm-hmm.
But do you know, some of the things that happen to us,
mm-hmm.
we never overcome them. And they play in our mind for such a long time.
Okay.
And it becomes who we are. And we will always attract who we are. And whatever we fear comes to us. So you sit down and you keep on seeing every man.
Mm.
This one may cheat on me, may cheat on me. That actually end up happening.
Mm.
So I would say you need to change your mind. Number one, think a new way.
Okay.
Number two, expect different. Because if you are sitting down and saying, I think all men are the same, you keep on seeing the same thing. Because that's what you're pulling towards yourself. You are thinking pattern every day, you are thinking that way. You can never go beyond where you are seeing.
Mm-hmm.
If you see a man as a cheat, eventually you will get one on your table and will cheat on you. In fact, the second one cheated on you 3 times.
Mm-hmm.
The first one was once.
Mm-hmm.
This one is 3 times. So the more you keep on thinking, now the other one may come like and cheat on you 10 times.
Mm-hmm.
So begin to change the way you are thinking. Relate also with people who have a positive story of their relationships, because that means also in their circles they have the right kind of men.
Mm. Okay.
And you are likely to get into the right relationship because you're hanging with the right people. But sit around with people who are saying, "Hata mimi nilitendewa hivyo." Hata mimi nilitendewa hivyo. So you create a stronghold among yourself and you begin to attract the same kind of reaction.
Okay.
Mm.
Wow. All right, that's interesting, because you know, sometimes you might think it must be something big, nilichapwa, or it might be something big, I was raped. So now, you know, but you know, simple things such as just thinking that all men are trash. Yeah.
Yeah, that's actually what I wanted to say.
Or all women are God knows what.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, there's that movement that was there that all men are that animal.
Dogs.
Mm.
Okay.
Let's just call it as it is. Wanasemanga yes. Dogi.
And you know what? That also influences the younger generation that's listening.
Okay.
That on its own can cause a trauma. When they hear the sisters, perhaps the older sisters saying, all men are dogs.
Mm.
Then the younger generation grows knowing the guy who will also perhaps propose to me will be a dog.
Mm.
No man is faithful, no man is this. And I want to say, a lot of those things are lies.
Mm.
If one potato is rotten in a sack, not all of them are rotten.
Mm. Toa hiyo mbaya.
Toa hiyo mbaya. And people should not be talking about all men or all women from Nyeri or wherever, Kabete.
Mm.
Let it be that one you married from Kabete.
Yes.
It can even be from Maasai land or wherever.
Mm.
Yeah, or it can be that one man. I think we need to make it, to stop generalizing. Yeah, because that general blanket is creating a lot of trauma among your peers and their listeners.
Okay.
Yeah.
There are traumas that are very deep, and especially the intimate ones, whereby a partner infected you with a very bad disease, or a partner raped you, or even a stranger just raped you, and now you're finding it very difficult to be intimate in your next relationship.
Mm.
How do we deal with a situation like that? Because I know of women, or other men who tell me about their women, like, hey, who you? Mtu wangu by that, hey, who you manzee anakuanga nika, your sector ni kama hayuko. Yeah.
No, it happens. Especially if you have been wounded in one way or another, especially as you're saying diseases, and probably rape and that kind of a thing, it can stop you from being able to do anything.
Mm.
But I usually say, you need also to learn the process of getting out of trauma. Number one, it is good to go through the detail of what happened. Accept it happened. Because, yes, and it is very bad. Rape happens.
Mm.
Sit with it and be able to go through it and accept that it has happened. Because as long as you're denying, because most people tend to block it off. People who succeed even in getting healed of cancer are the ones who, number one, accept, I have it. Not saying, I don't have it. I have it. Then you are able to marshal your energy towards fighting that disease.
Mm.
Accept that that thing happened. Then accept the experience and the pain. Because sometimes we don't grieve of what happened. You don't allow the anger, the resentment. You don't feel it.
Mm.
So because you don't feel it, you keep on denying it. It goes to the subconscious. And eventually, it will be triggered at one moment. Then set an end to what happened. Set an end. Decide that, yes, I know I'm feeling this anger, but I am going to look for a way to bring it to an end. It has to come to an end.
Yeah.
I refuse to continue this way. But if you just say that time will heal, it may not. It takes a decision to say, from now, I refuse to allow this anger, this resentment, this unforgiveness to continue beyond this time.
Yeah.
If the sadness hits you for a moment, you can wallow there, which is okay. You can wallow there in the sadness for an hour. But say, after 1 hour, I'm not going to allow this thing to happen.
Right.
Change the environment, change what you're thinking, and begin the process of working out on this. Because if you allow it to hold on you, then it will, number one, affect you personally.
Okay.
You will get diseases. You will get things that you may not be able to deal with in your physical body simply because you have not set a timeline. Ikitu lazima nimalize nayo.
So far, we've gotten reactions from you saying that this and this has happened. We need to also talk about solutions. And here's our question of the day as we take a break. How have you dealt with a past relationship traumatic experience? How have you dealt with a past relationship traumatic experience? K24 TV across all media platforms. And of course, right there on your screen is our WhatsApp number. Let us know if you're hurting and indeed how you've overcome that. Maybe someone else might actually get that help from you. Do not go too far. We'll be right back.